Hello, I'm Harold Weinbrecht, Mayor of Cary, and this is Cary Matters, the monthly program designed to help keep you informed about and involved in issues that we, the members of your town council, are working on as your elected representatives. Joining me as co-host this month is Don Frantz, our council representative for District B, and Don's been on our council since 2007. Don, thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
Are you ready to get started?
I sure am.
All right, why don't you give us a rundown of what's on this month's episode?
All right. Well, our big story this month is the expansion of the town's recycling program. And for our Q&A segment, we're going to be talking about our first big solar project and that question that everybody's been asking about, backyard chickens. So it's time for the big story, changes in Cary's recycling program.
Ah, very good topic. You might remember that in 2009, we added 4 new materials when we converted to rollout carts. And now, just 3 years later, we're adding 4 more items for recycling. Thanks to expanding technology, we're happy to announce that Cary Recycles program is now accepting metal and plastic lids, bagged shredded paper, metal pots and pans, and chipboard egg cartons and cup trays. However, we're still not accepting styrofoam at this time. These additional materials continue our trend of increasing the number of accepted items that our citizens can recycle either in their curbside recycling carts or bins or at the Citizens Convenience Center on North Dixon Avenue. You know, we're proud of our continued effort to support our citizens' interest in recycling. This is part of our commitment to taking care of our natural resources, and we hope that all of our citizens will take pride in the environmental health of our community by taking advantage of these newly accepted items in the Cary Recycles program.
Absolutely. And in addition to helping our environment, recycling also helps our wallets. During this past fiscal year, we diverted almost half of our curbside collections from the landfill to recycling, a whopping 11,331 tons of material. By diverting that material from the landfill, we saved almost $340,000 in tipping fees, which is what we, and by we I mean you, get charged to put stuff in the landfill. In addition to saving money at the landfill, we actually get money for what we recycle. Last year alone, we earned almost $332,000 from recycling. Oh, and in case you were wondering, we will not have to increase the number of trucks or staff to accommodate these additional materials, since the majority of them are lightweight.
And that's good news.
It is.
And if you're like my family and already put more in your recycling bin than in your trash bin, you may find that you need more space for recycling. And if so, ask to switch to the larger 95-gallon cart at no cost. Or you can request a second 65-gallon cart or a 95-gallon cart for the low, low price of just $1 more per month. But wait, I'm not finished. If you have that special occasion where you need a special collection for the special price of only $10, Public Works will drop by especially for you. So just call 919-469-4090 to schedule your special pickup.
Don't delay, act today. The first 100 callers receive a free set of Ginsu steak knives.
All right.
Just kidding.
Oh.
But get ready, because we're going to close out this section with the list of all the rest of the stuff that you can recycle here in Cary. Here it goes. Corrugated cardboard and chipboard, such as your empty cereal boxes and empty paper towel rolls. Newspapers, magazines, paper and junk mail, including postcards and windowed envelopes. Telephone books, glass bottles and jars, plastic bottles and tubs numbered 1 through 7. We don't take number 8. Metal cans and clean aluminum foil and pie pans. Cartons with a gable top, such as milk cartons. Aseptic packaging, which includes your drink, broth, and soup boxes.
Wow.
Whew, that wore me out.
I bet. Wore me out just listening to it. And if you can't remember all of that, what's acceptable for recycling, or you want to know what collection week is this week or next week, just go to Town Hall's website and search for recycling at www.townofcary.org. Well, coming up after the break, we're going to get to those questions you were talking about earlier, and the questions we've been getting a lot of from citizens.
dozen goblins, young and old. All the candy you can hold. Ghostly stories to be told. Haunted house for the bold. Fun that's silly and fun that's scary. Howlin' good with the town of Cary. Howlin' Good Halloween from October 23rd through the 31st. For complete details of events and activities, search Halloween at townofcary.org or call Parks, Recreation and Cultural Resources at 919-469-4061.
Salad on Saturday, fruit on Friday, throwable Thursday.
Water, water Wednesday, touch your toes Tuesday. Let's move Mondays, while the next Sunday.
60 minutes of physical activity a day and eating well can help get your child healthy. So keep them active and eating well every day. Get ideas, get involved, get going at letsmove.gov. That's letsmove.gov.
We're back. Thanks for staying with us. It's time now for us to address some of the questions the council's been getting from you. Don, what do you have?
Well, we've received a question about if we're using renewable energy or not, specifically solar energy. I know our bus shelters use solar for lighting and our school speed zone flashing lights are solar, but we have something really big coming up.
We sure do. And we are building one of the largest public-private solar farms in the state right here in Cary. Last month, our solar contractor, FLS Energy, broke ground on our farm at our South Cary Water Reclamation Facility. We're leasing the company about 8 acres for 5,918 panels, which will generate up to 1.8 megawatts of electricity, or roughly about enough energy to power 174 homes a year. In addition to the $35,000 they're paying the town to lease the land, FLS Energy is paying for all the construction, maintenance, and operation. Construction should be finished in November, weather permitting. Now, this project was only possible because our successful legislative efforts. Last year, the town was granted special authority from the North Carolina General Assembly to enter into leases of up to 20 years for the purposes of generating renewable energy. We're excited about the new venture as we continue to look for new ways to expand our sustainable efforts, especially when they make sense, and I mean sense with a C.
Absolutely. Well, we've also received many, many questions over the last few weeks about backyard chickens.
Oh yeah, we sure have.
People want to know if they're allowed in Cary, and if so, what rules apply. Well, I'm happy to say that on August 23rd, the town council approved the keeping of a limited number of chickens in most residential areas of Cary. Here's the deal. You can have a maximum of 5 hens, no roosters. The hens, or as I call them, chickens, I'll set him right there, have to be kept in a coop or a pen or a portable chicken tractor. They just can't run around the yard. We don't allow any rogue chickens in Cary. And these chicken pens can't be your house or your garage or other residential structure. It's got to be a place just for chickens. Now, all of your chickens have to stay in the chicken coop at night. However, during the day, they can roam around their chicken pen. The coops, pens, and the chicken tractors have to be and stay in your backyard. And don't put them within 15 feet of any side or rear property line. And one more thing, they are your chickens, so they need to be closer to your house than your neighbors. That way, if any smells or issues arise, they will come to your attention before your neighbors. If you do want chickens, you'll need to come to town hall for a permit and pay the one-time $50 fee. And remember, I said that we expanded the parts of Cary where chickens can be included to include most of Cary. Well, I chose those words carefully because if you're on a lot that's less than 6,000 square feet, you still can't have chickens. And this is very important, if your homeowners association prohibits the keeping of chickens, no matter how big your lot is, you still can't have chickens. HOA covenants trump town code. You agreed to those rules and covenants when you bought your home, and that is a private agreement between you and your homeowners association. if you're confused, don't be. All of this information is available on the Town of Cary's website at townofcary.org. Think we ought to put this chicken back in the coop now?
I sure do.
All right.
Anything else, Don, other than chickens?
Well, we actually probably should remind everybody about the upcoming community investment bonds that'll be on the November ballot.
Very good idea. Well, go right ahead.
Okay. Well, on the ballot, there will be three questions for a total of $80 million. The questions will ask taxpayers for permission to borrow money in the form of general obligation bonds to pay for a new fire station, improve transportation, and build new parks and greenways. We've talked about the fire and the parks bonds in previous Cary Matters, so here's the rundown on the transportation bonds. It's about $58 million, includes traffic improvements, resurfacing, intersection improvements, streetscape improvements, new traffic signal system software, sidewalks, bike facilities, bridge improvements, road widenings, a number of other transportation projects. If the voters approve all three of these bond questions, property tax rates in Cary will increase by 2 cents in 2013 and another 2 cents in 2015.
That's right. And if folks vote no on the bond, it's important to know that the projects likely won't move ahead for the next 3 to 5 years based on the current revenue projections. There's a special website, carrybonds.org, that serves as a central information resource for the bonds and the individual projects they will fund. So check it out and be informed about the bonds. Okay, good stuff. Well, after the break, we're going to give you some insights of what's coming up at Town Hall and how you can be involved.
Read to a child today and spark a lifetime of ambition.
We're back in this final segment of Cary Matters. We want to talk about what's happening in October and how you can be involved. Don, besides Halloween, what else is going on in October?
Well, in the month of October, we actually have three work sessions and two council meetings scheduled. The first work session is on October 9th, and it's actually more of a celebration. That is the night we thank our many volunteers on our town advisory boards.
That's right. And the second and third work sessions are scheduled for October the 11th and October the 25th. At the time of this taping, the topics were not finalized, so we really don't know what's going on in those work sessions yet. Our two council meetings are on the second and fourth Thursdays of the month, and that would also be on October 11th and October the 25th.
Well, that's it for this edition of Cary Matters. We appreciate your watching and hope that what we've shared has been of interest. Please let us hear from you. Your time is important, and we want this show to be of value to you as we work to bring you, our citizens, closer to your government.
That's right. And remember, help keep Cary litter-free, clean, green, and beautiful by volunteering with our Spruce program. Thanks for watching, and as always, thanks for choosing to call Cary home.
This has been a production of Cary TV. Visit the Town of Cary's website at townofcary.org.